Silvia. Welcome to the Meet the Brain series.
Thank you.
So, what's your research interest?
My research interest is neurodegeneration, and in particular, working in Huntington's disease.
And could you explain Huntington's disease?
Yes, so Huntington's disease is a neurodegenerative disease that is caused by a mutation in a gene that is called Huntington. And the HD patients manifest motor symptoms, but for our research, most importantly, cognitive deficits and psychiatric disturbances.
And what is exciting about it?
I think that the most exciting part is to know how the brain works, because the brain makes what we are, and makes it's important for our thinking, for what I'm doing. So, and this complexity, I think it's so exciting to know how it's working.
How do you reach your research goals?
We are using in the lab different mice models, disease mice models, that reproduce the mutation. And we use several behavioral tests trying to know if by targeting some specific pathway or some specific molecule, we can improve the symptoms related with HD.
Who are your partners in your research?
So I think the collaboration in science is critical. I mean that without collaboration, it's impossible to do almost everything. So I have collaborations in Madrid, in Salamanca, Boston, Ireland, I think that everywhere almost.
And what are you most looking forward to?
So as I said before, I think that the most important thing is to know how the brain works, with the main or with the final goal to try to help people, and specifically HD people, to improve the quality of life.
And how can your research change the world?
Probably I'm not going to change the world in a general view, no. I hope to, as I said before, change the quality of life of HD patients and also the caregivers, because it's a disease that is so hard and there's no cure for HD now.
What's next in your field of research?
I think that trying to prevent neurodegeneration, there's a lot of different therapeutics that try to ameliorate or try to slow, but still there's nothing about prevention of neurodegeneration.
How do you celebrate a new paper being published?
So with my team and with some, or maybe more than some beers.
Who or what is your inspiration?
So the inspiration, I think, is the life itself. So trying to know in our case, how the brain is working and how this complexity makes the brain function.
If you could have a coffee with a scientist from the past, who would it be?
So Santiago Ramón y Cajal, because if I'm here and if I study biochemistry, really time ago, was thanks to a TV movie that was just explaining the life of Ramón y Cajal.
What's the best thing that has happened in your career?
So I think that meet colleagues that now are good friends.
What would you say to your younger self when you were starting your scientific career?
So probably that, I don't know, keep working because it's worth it.
And finally, what would you like to say to the world?
That science is crucial, research is crucial to really improve our lives, and we need to really fund a lot of projects to get really good life.
Thank you, Silvia.
Thank you too.